What is going on, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Chef Lee Off Duty. Today I'm going to be making my own version of KFC wings with a sweet and spicy buffalo sauce. It's going to be really nice, really easy. I haven't done it before, so this is kind of a bit of an experiment, so you're going to come along with the journey with me and see how it turns out. Hopefully it goes to plan, hopefully it tastes as nice as I would want it to be. So yeah, we're going to get down into the kitchen, we're going to make this thing happen. So yeah, sit back, relax, chill, and watch me do my thing. See you in a bit. Right, so I've got about half a block of butter, which I used previously on another video, so I might as well use it now. So this is how I'm going to make my buffalo sauce. Did some research and found out one way to make it, but I'm going to adapt it a little bit to the way, well, for the ingredients that I have. So I'm just throwing in my 125 grams of unsalted butter, just whacking in some caster sugar. I have no real measurements for this because I'm just literally doing it on the fly, and then just bring that up to the heat a little bit, let that melt, and then I'm going to add some barbecue sauce. I know it says for steak, but it's for chicken, it's meat, it's going to work. So a good few glugs of that in there, as you can see. Oh, that's going to be calorific and very, very rich. And then when it boils down and settles down a little bit, I'll move it over to the back. I'll move it over to here and then just leave it on low. Or I might move it onto that one there because that's low. Get a whisk. Just whisk it. Also, I'm going to add a bit of honey to it just to add to a little bit of extra flavour. And obviously I'm going to test it as well, because I might need to add just a little bit more to it, or adjust the flavour to how I want my wings. This is the first time I'm actually making this type of buffalo sauce. Actually, it's supposed to be spicy, and there's nothing in here that's spicy, so I'm going to add some Scotch bonnet sauce. So I'm using some Dunn's River hot pepper sauce. And just throw that in, a bit in there, a few drops. Then I'll taste that in a bit. And then if I need to add some more, I'll add some more. If not, then I won't. It's got a good colour to it though. I should bottle this stuff, to be fair. If it tastes nice. Now let me just test it with a spoon. See if I need to adjust it a little bit. Might need to add some salt and pepper, but not bad, not bad. Gonna add some more spice. And then I'm just going to move you out of the way a sec so I can get some pepper. There we go. Turn it all the way down. It's very rich. Right, where's the whisk? Whisk that in a little bit. In fact, I don't even think I need to put that on a boil anymore. Just leave it as it is on the side. It's not as spicy as I'd like, so I'm just gonna whack quite a few drops in there. Just add a little bit more. Spoon a quick wash and taste again. Got a good colour to it though, I must admit. That's better. Might whack in a little bit of honey. Now this honey we got from Koss last year, and the company don't sell abroad. This is it. It's really good stuff. As you can see, we've been using it. Well, I've been using it quite a lot. I really wish you'd get this stuff over here. There we go. In fact, I am going to move it over to the smallest hob and turn it right the way down. Right, next it's on with the chicken. So next up is to fry the actual chicken itself and season it. So first off, I'm going to start with a bit of corn flour. Just to coat it. And then some salt. Sorry, pepper. Now I'll put some salt in there. And then a little bit of meat seasoning. I think this came from America. I think my in-laws brought it when I went to America last time. So I've got that, and then I'm going to add some cumin. Make sure you can see that. Some cumin, just a few taps, probably about a teaspoon or two teaspoons, and then some buffalo seasoning. Because I am trying to make buffalo wings, so just shake it a bit loose. There we go. So again, about 2 teaspoons full. I'm just going to mix it up. So if you've already seen my previous videos, you know that I always wash my chicken, I clean it. These are just chicken wings that I've cut down to niblet size. Add a bit more flour. Nicely mixed. So I've just got a bowl of milk. There you go. And then in the other bowl, that bowl there, I'm going to use a combination of Dunn's River frying chicken seasoning and this one as well. Let me just move that out of the way and bring this in over here so you can see. You can use them separately, but I like to mix them. I think it gives a better flavour. So that's that one there, and then that one. In fact, I used the rest of that because that's nearly finished. That's done, so move that out of the way. So that's the two seasonings mixed together. And during this time, I've had a pan of oil on the heat, warming up. So hopefully it should be ready. That sauce has actually, just move you over, that sauce has come down by about half. You can see the little line where it started off from. And it's got a nice rich flavour. Well, a rich colour, not flavour. What am I talking about? Get your head in the game, Chef Lee. Right, so I'm going to do one at a time. Well, just so I can see if the oil is hot enough. So, got one there. Roll it around. Shake it off. Now, hopefully that oil is now hot enough, but we shall see. Let me just turn it up first, because that would always work. But it's been on a little while, so it should be semi-warm. As you can see. I'm going to leave that in there for a few minutes, and then see how it turns out. And then if it's how I want it to turn out, then I'll do the rest of them. So like I said, I've just done one chicken bit, and it's turned out pretty much the way I wanted it to. Now, I don't know, it's not fully cooked yet, because I want to put it in the oven just to finish it off, but I'm just going to slice it open to see. So you can see it's not quite cooked. If I left it in a little bit longer, it would have been cooked, but I want to finish them off in the oven. So because I've got such a lot, I don't want some sitting out, you know, and making someone else. So that one's gone in the bin now, because I'm not going to use that one. So now I'm going to run through time lapse, and you'll be able to see me doing them as it happens in time lapse, because it'll take about 10-15 minutes, and the video is already going to be long enough because I've still got chips to make it. So yeah, I'm going to go into time lapse, and you'll see me frying off the chicken. So, little side note, while I was filming the time lapse for the frying of the chicken, for some reason it didn't work properly. The file's corrupted, so I'm gonna have to just skip past that, and you'll just see the end product when it's all done and going into the oven. Sorry about that, but that's just the way technology works sometimes. Back to the video. So as you can see, the chicken is done frying. So now it's just gonna go in the oven for about half an hour on a low heat, just to finish cooking. And then I'm going to do a little bit of a clean up, because the kitchen looks like a bomb's hit it. And then I'm going to bring you back in when I'm going to make my homemade chips using the same oil. This oil will be thrown away by the end of when I finish cooking, so I won't be using it again. So I've just got the oven on gas mark 5, turn it down to gas mark 4, and I'm just going to leave that in there. In fact, I'm going to turn it down to 3. Just leave it in there just to keep cooking through. And they're going to clean down the kitchen, because it looks like a bit of a mess. And then I will bring you back in once I'm going to make my chips. So I will see you in a sec. Right, so now that I've cleaned the kitchen, make it look like someone professional works here, I'm going to make my chips with the skin on. I'm not going to make them overly thick. Get rid of that, because I don't want that in my chips. Yeah. going to get rid of that in general. So these are just red potatoes. I prefer red potatoes in my, when I'm making stuff. So I'm going to par fry these and then leave them to sit and then finish them off a little bit later. And if you're wondering why I always put my the lid on the pan when it's frying, is just try and reduce the amount of splashing that comes out. So, in with the fries. And it also keeps the temperature up as well. Helps get the temperature up. Right, so quite didn't go to plan as I wanted. I did say that I was gonna only parv fry them, but I ended up on a phone call that lasted longer than I thought. So they're now actually fully fried. So now I'm just gonna take them out. Bit of kitchen towel to dry them off. And then what I like to do is just add a little bit of salt when they're fresh out of the fryer. Let me get the salt. Without dropping everything all over the place, will it happen? Yes, it will. So just a little bit of salt. And then that's it. Right, and now it is just the plating up of the food. So here's the chicken that I've just taken out of the oven. And there's the sauce. So let me get a plate. Get a few chips. There we go. And then just a little bit of sauce on top. good as it looked. It was really, really nice. I'm definitely going to make that again. I'm going to add a little bit more spice next time to the sauce, but for me, I like a spicy sauce. Others don't. My wife doesn't. She can't really do that many spices, so what can I say? What can I tell you? Anyway, thank you for making it to the end of this video. I will leave all my links to my social media in the top right hand corner of the screen. Please like, share, and subscribe because it helps out the channel. I'm still trying to get to my first 1,000 subscribers. More videos to come. So again, please like, share, and subscribe, and I will catch you in the next one. Peace.